everyone, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Irina, and I'm so glad to welcome each and every one of you here. Today, we're going to learn some essential phrasal verbs related to clothing. So, grab a notebook if you like writing things down like I do, and also a cup of hot tea or a cup of coffee if you wish, and let's get started. Before we start, please support this video by giving it a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so. And now, without further ado, let's get started.
Let's get started.
And let's start with these two absolutely essential phrasal verbs, put on and take off. So, I'm putting on my hat. I'm putting on my hat. I'm taking off my hat. I've just taken off my hat. I'm sure you already know these two phrasal verbs. However, remember that these phrasal verbs are considered as separable. What do I mean by that? So, if you have a separable phrasal verb, it means you can say either put something on or put on something, take something off, or take off something. So I can either say, I'm putting on my hat, or you can also say, I'm putting my hat on. So you can separate the phrasal verb. In this case, it's separable. The same happens with take off. I am taking off my hat, or I'm taking my hat off. That's it.
Ah! Take it off! Take it off!
Take off your coat!
Can I take my coat off?
Now, with these two common phrasal verbs out of the way, let's continue with some other more advanced phrasal verbs. And next on the list is button up. So, you know what a button is? This is a button. So, when you button up a piece of clothing, it means you fasten your piece of clothing using buttons. For example, on my shirt, I have some buttons. So what am I gonna do now? I'm going to button up my shirt. I'm going to button up. I'm buttoning up my shirt. Okay? The opposite would be to unbutton. However, unbutton isn't a phrasal verb. So I am unbuttoning my shirt.
Button up, kids. I'm going back to work.
Now, you unbuttoned all your buttons I buttoned up.
Button up your jacket. Sit up straight.
One more example. This is Angelica. What is Angelica doing? She's helping her son to button up his shirt as he's getting ready for school. So she's helping her son button up or to button up his shirt. She's helping her son to fasten the buttons on his shirt. Button up. Next on the list is to zip up. So if you have a zipper instead of buttons on your piece of clothing, you're going to say to zip up. To zip up basically means to fasten the zipper on a piece of clothing.
You should zip up your jacket.
Could you zip me up?
Forget to zip up your fly. If you don't zip up your fly, a seagull will get you.
One more phrasal verb that I think you should know is this one, to throw on. So when you throw a piece of clothing on, when you throw something on, it means you put it on quickly because you are late or you're in a hurry or something like this. Oh no. I'm late for work, yet again. My boss is gonna kill me. Okay. So, as you've seen, this girl was late for work. And she didn't have much time to spend on choosing her outfit. So what she did was to throw on the first jacket she could find and run out of the house. So to throw something on means to put it on very quickly.
Oh, God.
Sorry, guys. Let me throw something on.
Next on the list is to dress up. Well, to dress up has two different meanings. The first meaning of dress up is to wear a costume that makes you look like something else or someone else. For example, you can dress up as a ghost, you can dress up as a cowboy, you can dress up as a dinosaur, whatever. For example, all the children at the party had dressed up as dinosaurs. The second meaning of this phrasal verb to dress up is to wear formal and usually elegant clothes. For example, you don't have to dress up to go to the mall. Jeans and a t-shirt would be fine. So you don't have to wear formal, elegant, and beautiful clothes to go to the mall. It's not necessary. Jeans and a t-shirt would be fine. You don't have to dress up.
So I dressed up as a prison guard.
On Halloween, she was dressed up as Batman.
And Bobby dressed up as Tarzan, and I dressed up as Jane.
Wait, who are you dressed up as?
One more phrasal verb that I think you need to know is this one, go with. So when one piece of clothing goes with another piece of clothing, it means they look good together. They match. It can be the color, the overall style, whatever. They go with each other. For example, I think that this blue jacket doesn't go very well with this leopard scarf. What do you think? I think it doesn't go with the scarf. I think the jacket doesn't go with the scarf. It looks terrible. What do you think?
Hey, baby, which one of these ties goes better with my shirt?
Buy me a shirt and tie to go with this.
I think that Gemma's shoes go really well with her new dress. Her new shoes go really well with her new dress. What do you think? Next on the list is to show off. If you show off a piece of clothing, it means you are proud of this piece of clothing and you want everyone to see it and admire it. For example, this guy over here is proud of his expensive clothes and jewelry, so he's showing off his very expensive clothes and jewelry.
Showing off our sportsito.
Thomas likes to show off.
One more important phrasal verb is to come out. Well, when we're speaking about a stain, some dirt, a mark that is on a piece of clothing, for example, in my case, it's a kitchen towel. So since I cook a lot, I use this kitchen towel a lot, there are some stains on it. So I'm not quite sure if these stains will eventually come out, if I'll be able to wash this kitchen towel until it's completely clean and stainless. Oh, there is a red wine stain on her white shirt. Do you think it will come out? I don't think so. I don't think this stain will come out.
The stain's not coming out. I'm gonna put it on her.
Yeah, some stains just don't come out.
The stain is not coming out.
Next on the list is to hang up. So if you hang up a piece of clothing, it means you place it on a hook. Well, I don't have a hook here, but let's imagine there is one. So you place it on a hook, you hang it up, or a hanger, on a hanger. So I'm going to hang my jacket up. I'm going to hang up my jacket so that it doesn't get wrinkled.
Hello there, Ham. Better hang up your coat and wash your
hang up your jacket.
Let's also look at these two phrasal verbs, to grow into and to grow out of. What's the difference between these two phrasal verbs? Well, we usually use them when we talk about kids, children, teenagers who grow quickly. For example, these shoes are too big for Carly. However, she'll grow into them. It means she will eventually become big enough to wear these shoes. So she will grow into these shoes in a couple of years. And the opposite would be to grow out of. Well, we know that toddlers, children, teenagers grow quickly. They became bigger and taller in no time at all, and their clothes become smaller for them so that they can't wear them anymore, which means that they grow out of their clothes. They grow out of their clothes. For example, this boy has definitely grown out of his clothes, and I think he'll just have to give them to his little brother. He has grown out of his clothes. He's too big for his clothes now.
I'm packing away the clothes Charlie's grown out of.
These are some clothes that my nephew's grown out of.
And I can't let you go without teaching you these two final and very important phrasal verbs. So let's continue talking about sizes of clothing. Now let's imagine you've bought an item of clothing that's a little bit too big for you. So what do you have to do? Well, of course you can throw it away, but you can also take it in. So if you take in a piece of clothing, it means you make it smaller. For example, as we can see, this girl has bought a beautiful red dress. However, it's a little bit too big for her. So she might need to take it in a little. If she wants to make it smaller, if she wants this dress to fit her very well, she'll have to take it in, make it smaller, take it in. On the contrary, if you have a piece of clothing that's a little bit too tight for you, a little bit too small for you, you have to let it out, make it bigger in size. For example, this girl has bought a new pair of jeans. However, they are a little bit too tight for her, a little bit too small. So in order to wear them comfortably, she'll have to let them out a little. She'll have to let them out. She'll have to make them bigger in size. Oh, and she has also found a shirt that she used to wear 5 years ago. As we can see, this shirt is too tight for her, but she still wants to wear it because she really likes it. So she'll have to let it out. She'll have to let it out. Let it out.
Are you letting out my pants?
Also, if you live in a cold place where the weather is harsh, cold, if it's freezing outside, these two phrasal verbs might come in handy. To wrap up and to bundle up. Since I'm getting ready to go for a walk and I live in a pretty cold place, there is plenty of snow outside, so what am I gonna do? I'm going to wrap up before going outside because I don't want to catch a cold. So I'm going to bundle up or wrap up before going outside. Wrap up and bundle up.
As you can see, it's freezing in my town, so I am wrapped up. I had to wrap up. I had to bundle up before going outside. See, it's freezing.
Have to bundle up, everyone.
Make sure you bundle up because it is freezing out there.
Do bundle up. It's awfully cold outside.
Well, that's gonna be it for today. I know it's been a very long lesson, but still, I really hope you've learned something new and useful today. Please support this video by giving it a like and thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and also leave your feedback in the comment section. Well, thanks so much for watching till the very end. You're truly the best, guys. Thank you so much. I'll see you in our next lessons. Have a great day. Bye.